Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, and we're talking about what's out there now at the movies. Okay, the big one. I mean, why should we even fool around? The big one is called Fast and Furious. Look, it could just as easily be called Slow and Stupid, because it's both of those things as well. So it must sound like I'm going to throw this whole movie into the scum bucket. No, I'm going to throw a lot of it into the scum bucket, but not all of it. So see, I am a charitable person at heart. I have to start, though, by saying Fast and Furious, didn't we just see that movie in 2001 with Vin Diesel and Paul Walker? We did, but see, it was called The Fast and The Furious. Now they took the pesky little the, got rid of it, got rid of the second the, now it's Fast and Furious, and it's all new again. Because we all know that Vin Diesel, Dominic, didn't want to do the second movie because they weren't giving him enough money to do it. Ha! So he didn't. The second movie didn't make as much. Cute title, Too Fast, Too Furious. By the time of the third movie, Tokyo Drift, it was called The Fast and the Furious, Tokyo Drift. Vin wasn't there. Although I've got to say, thank all of you people out there that reach me at asktravers@rollingstone.com. who said to me, you're a big liar. Vin Diesel was actually in Tokyo Drift. There's a lot of controversy in this office about that. All right, I'm going to break the critics' rule. It's a whole rule of ethics that we follow, that we don't give away cameos that are surprises. But one of you did say, look, the movie's old. Who cares? And I don't even go by that, because you could see it on DVD. But Tokyo Drift is a piece of crap. So I'm going to break the critical rule of ethics and say, yes, Vin Diesel shows up for about a minute and a half in a surprise cameo in Tokyo Drift. And if your life is so bereft of everything that you want to watch that movie, go ahead and do it. Back to the matter at hand. Cars in this movie are the reason you see it. Cars and the babes. There's a great Lamborghini in it. It's wow. And then you could do the muscle cars versus the imports. Have your opinions about that. I loved to look at that. Jordana Brewster and Michelle Rodriguez come back to the movie. Both of them are great looking. But the movie is stupid beyond reason. It doesn't make any sense. Vin comes back. The cops are chasing him, but they can't find him because he's in downtown LA doing racing. Can't find him? Where is he living? With his sister. They know the address. What? Stupid, stupid, stupid. Anything that is a plot in this movie belongs in the scum bucket. It's going in there.
You know each other?
He used to date my sister.
You're a lucky man.
How's that?
You're still breathing.
All right, but you're going to see it, and I know you are anyway. And I'm saying we're living in a time where everybody's got tough times and we want to escape. Why not escape with Fast and the Furious? I ain't stopping you. So is there anything good out there? Well, the other big movie is called Adventureland. It is directed by Greg Mottola, who did Superbad, but you got to remember that Superbad had a script by Seth Rogen and his partner Evan Goldberg. This is not like that. Adventureland is about an amusement park in 1987 where a lot of kids work when they're off the summer from college. And two of those kids are played by Jesse Eisenberg and, are you ready, Kristen Stewart. Kristen Stewart from Twilight. An actress who was on the periphery of things and did smaller parts, bigger parts, but movies people didn't really see. You all saw Twilight, and now there's big controversy. I hear it all the time. Do you really like Kristen Stewart? Look, I think she's a terrific actress. Twilight, you know, except for her and Rob Pattinson, nobody had a chance to act. In this one, she's a college girl. She's working there this summer. Jesse Eisenberg is a virgin. There's always a virgin in this kind of movie. And he's in love with her. He's pining for her. But she's having an affair with an older married man played by Ryan Reynolds, who is utterly miscast in this movie. I don't know what he's doing in it, but whatever he does doesn't work. What does work in this movie are Bill Hader and Kristen Wiig, both from Saturday Night Live, and both terrific. They're the married couple that runs the amusement park. And just watching their faces while they're looking at what's going on with the same story. I mean, that's the thing. 1987, you get to hear that kind of soundtrack. You get to hear Rock Me Amadeus. I didn't care because it didn't surprise me. As good as Kristen Stewart and Jesse Eisenberg are, they can't make me think that there's something new, something fresh, something to be discovered in Adventureland. So I'm only just okay about it. All right. I told you that parts of Fast and Furious go in the scum bucket, and I've got to go back because last week I did it again. I looked at a trailer of The Haunting in Connecticut, and I said, this looks like crap. So I went to The Haunting in Connecticut to show you that I do these things for you. Next week, I'm actually going to see Hannah Montana. I mean, who else makes supreme sacrifices like this? But The Haunting in Connecticut official review is, it stinks. It is awful in any way. There's nothing scary in it. I personally am more frightened by the McDonald's commercial that goes, give me back that fillet fish, give me that fish, give me back that fillet fish, give me that fish.
What if it were you hanging up on this?
If you were in that sandwich, you wouldn't be laughing at all. Why does that freak me out? Am I alone? Are there people out there like me that just want to take that commercial and say, go away, and that give you nightmares? If you feel like I do, contact me at asktravers@rollingstone.com or on Twitter. Yeah, I got the tweets. I got everything. So call me. Find any way that you can reach me, and we will discuss this further when I'm back next week discussing great movies like Hannah Montana. I'm Peter Travers. Give me back that fillet fish. Give me that fish.